the first to know. This is the Comet Show. Make Comet Show way. Comrade Lamte Oriente, live on Facebook and YouTube. Like us. Follow us and be the first to know. This is the Comet Show. Make Comet Show way. Comrade Lamte Oriente, live on Facebook and YouTube. Like us. Follow us and be the first to know. Make Comet Show way. Comrade Lamte Oriente, live on Facebook and YouTube. Like us. Follow us and be the first to know. This is the Comet Show.
Yes, hello, Ilia Donuzomo. Ibota Nahi. This is the Comrade Show, Ibota on the Comrade Show. And Meno Imiagbadia, Mousa Nuyoria, you know, Lantel Yuvan, Zanima, Isuan, Yasuan, Mamoe Sune, where Mamina Nasa Yone, where Edo, Ebunimahune, no we. Yimabo Ruda where if you ever man the book at the cat in the road work in the risi ni bring my emo boze do or you know me where imaido imaiwa I sendo a yiki and my you look and say yo where mani boom ni be ni me mo runia to we my emo botu ruma to it no ba mana be yasel yo tassel yo where I can't hear the doha when I la wo in my beer, Katakati Timani wrote me risi, Sunibun, Nimirowa, Nimasuan Maya, a do, in no heki a no. And Mabi Lebe Urumato, where so eh, Nemoa Yore, in no heki a car, where they are to wear, if you be a kibe a deal, a manivy dean, even a dobonia, ye Urunato, where ni. On your way, identity already do. So for my brothers and my sisters and, you know, the people who across the world who may not know exactly what I'm talking about right now, we're going to try to take a study right now into some of the basics of the Edo language, because we've identified that the Edo language is fast, you know, losing, we are fast losing our grip on Edo language. Our people, you know, have, you know, opted to speak foreign languages, including English and some other languages, you know, of course, living in, you know, Benin language. And of course, this is a huge threat to the language itself. And while we are alive, we must do everything that we can to see how we can, you know, support the agenda of, you know, sort of a rebirth, if you may. You understand what I'm saying? Now, of course, we need to revitalize the language, make it a bit more present in our individual homes, you know, with our family. I'm very concerned about our children. And so, in the course of this study, wherever you are, you're watching this program, you know, please bring your children together. Let the children come together. Let us, you know, have this interaction. I'm going to be starting with ABCD, okay? Benin alphabet. And that's what I'm going to be starting with right now. Because it's the basis. You understand? You want to have to learn Benin language, particularly for the children that we have not taught this language. Some of them are already going to school. So, the fact that they are already in school, probably a lot of them are probably learning English. You understand what I'm saying? It will be helpful because what we are going to be doing is A, B, C, D, but this time in Benin language. And it's going to be helpful because, again, you know, like we say, Edo or Dion, you know, Benin, Edo is the eldest. You know, when you even look at English letters, alphabets, you find out that the pronunciation, you know, talking about phonetics in letters, okay, it's actually in here. This is actually the base of what's it called, of phonetics, as far as English letters, you know, are concerned, as it were. So we're going to learn some of those things in the course of this broadcast. However, I'm just going to take us through the very base, you know, of this. So let's bring our children together so that we can learn from base. We start from here. It's very important. So, Nala Wu, I beat him higher soon. So, now if you more could be, you make it now, you can't survive you be. But you can't be, you can't be, or can't be, or can't be, or can't be. Not even so. This is A in English, but it's R in a Edo language. So, yeah, for the sake of this program, yeah, I can have said, I will speak, you know, Benin a lot. So, let's try to pick up and follow. So, let's start. This is A, B, D, A, E, F, G, H, I, K, L, M, O, R, P, R, C, T, U, V, W, Y, Z. Those are the basic, you know, alphabets in Edo language. I call them basic. Meanwhile, we have two-letter alphabets as well. Okay, but I'm not going to be dealing with that in this study. I'm going to like us to want to get used to this before we now begin to insert those two-letter alphabets. Because all of these, they are part of the pronunciations in Benin language. So if you must speak Benin well, or you must pronounce Benin very well, or you must read and understand Benin very well, Benin is very straightforward, it's easy, okay? Particularly looking at it from the literary perspective, in that you pronounce as spelled, okay? If you say owo, or we all, owo. You say emi, emi e, emi e, emi e in, emi, oma, o me and me, okay? Oma, all me and me, okay? Depends on that. So it's majorly, you know, a spell as pronounced. Obo, or b o, obo, you know, or here, b here, o here, obo, and that's how we are pronounced it. So it is not, there are no do the resorti. You understand what I'm saying? It's all very straight, you know, forward as it were. So, but let's recount this. Say after me: A, B, D, A, F, G, H, I, K, L, M, N, O, R, P, R, C, T, U, V, W, Y, Z. Now let's you see these are the alphabets, basic ones. Like I said earlier, you know, let's not forget, you know, I did say that we have equally, you know, some two letter alphabets. They are there. We have B, G, B. Okay, we have R, G, H. We have B, K, P. We have V, M, W. We have V, B. Okay, these are the basic ones, I think. B, R, B, M, V. So, you look at it, these are the two, but we are not going to be dealing with this right now, because we want to have this basis so that we know where we can fit in this two-letter alphabet. Now, what I'm teaching right now is as much as I know. I in the course of time, we'll bring some scholars, those who know more than we do, to help us expatiate or deepen this particular study. But it's essential we start from this basis, this periphery. At least this we can teach. This, you know, we can learn from. So now, let us do this again. Forget about these two-letter alphabets. Let's deal with these ones first. These are the basic ones. So let's say after me. Let's say together: A, B, D, A, F, G, H, I, K, L, M, N, O, R, P, R, C, T, U, V, W, Y, Z. Now, importantly, let's get to understand something. The scholars of the Edo language that helped, the Benin language that helped put this together, okay, I give kudos to them because they are like people who saw tomorrow. The Edo language is very basic to almost every language in this world, you know. There's something about this alphabet that is reflective of all other alphabets. It looks almost like the Edo language is the foundation of language in this world, okay? But I'm just speculating, you understand what I'm saying? But the Benin language you know, based on this alphabet, it looks like it is the father of all other languages. But meanwhile, that remains to be argued. I said this because earlier I did talk about, you know, phonetics. Some of you children, you do phonetics in school, okay? You look at the letters and the pronunciation. In phonetics, in letter A is A in English, okay? But actually, the phonetic expression of A is A. And here in the Dodo language, we don't have to pass through a gob, the ogbe dinizoti, you know, pass through, you know, miles. It's A. It is pronounced A. And meanwhile, the English language, they pronounce it A, but they pronounce it as A in most cases. Okay? But we pronounce it as A because that's how it is actually pronounced even in the words. You understand? So A. For instance, Agbo. Agbo. You see now? A. Okay? Agbo. A. Adam. Ah, you see, so you can actually find it as pronounced, and that is what makes Edo language, you know, the mother of all languages. And that's why the people will say Edo Odion, Edo Isiagbo. You know, it means Edo is the eldest. Edo is the cradle of life, the cradle of civilization. You understand? Now, where those are coming from, I don't really know, but some of these things they reflect, those thoughts and of course those parables. And so as an Edo person, a Benin person, you're going to be very proud because your heritage is one that is having very close affinity with the Creator himself. You understand? So but anyway, all this remain to be, you know, there are things, I mean, they remain, you know, to be argued. You understand what I'm saying? But I'm just telling you based on what we can put together. You understand what I'm saying? So phonetically, you know, this alphabet, okay, when you apply them to, you know, to the Edo language, so you spell as pronounced. You understand what I'm saying now? You spell as pronounced. So later when I start, you know, going into the two letter alphabets, they all begin to make a lot of sense to us. Okay, this A, B, D, A. Now, something, you must take note of something here. This A, this in English is E. Actually, pronunciation of in English is either, you know, is mostly, in some cases with E, you understand, but most of the times, E. You understand what I'm saying? And so, depending on how well you are pronouncing the Edo language, it's either A or E. You understand? And most cases in English is A or E. In few cases, you have them E. You understand what I'm saying now? So, in this case, depending on what you are pronouncing in Edo language, it's either A or E. A, B, D, A, E. For instance, E. Okay? E. E. This E. This, the difference between them in writing is that E is standing on its own, but A, the A is standing on its own as E. Then this one is standing with a small hyphen beneath it or a dot or whatever you want to put there to differentiate between them. For instance, Ege. Ebo. Now these are two different things. Now A for this. E for Ege. Ebo. Ege. You understand? So like that. So depending on what you are pronouncing. You understand what I'm saying? And that's how we use, you know, these, you know, letters or alphabet as it were. So, A, B, D, A, F, G, H, I, K, L, M, N, O, O. We have O, we have O. Okay? O. In English is O. In Edo is O. But again, there are some other usage. Instead of O, it is O. O with a small hyphen beneath it. Or O, a dot beneath it to differentiate between two of them. You understand what I'm saying now? In Edo language, we have O-go-go. O-go-go. Now, O starts it. O comes in to the middle and the end. You understand what I'm saying now? O-go-go. O-go. This one now becomes O. O-go. Okay? So, it depends exactly on what you are pronouncing and the language, you know, what you are pronouncing and or what you are spelling, you know, that determines what you use in this case. But importantly, in Benin, you know, things are spelled as pronounced. So Wangenia, A B D A F E G E E K L E M I N I O O P R I C T U V W I Z. So ni mo e camera si koe mame ke na dege evini ma iwe gaeni alphabet in Benin ni maka abo among children let's take note of these, let's learn from these are the basic ones. In our next study, we are going to try to look at the two-letter alphabet and begin to see how we can apply these ones to our everyday pronunciations in Benin. These are the basics, you know, that we need to learn as far as Edo language is concerned. Honestly, now we need more the camera to call it. We need A, B, D, A, F, G, H, I, K, L, M, N, O, O, P, R, C, T, U, V, W, Y, Z. If you don't know, you can't get around. So, I don't know, I don't know. Okay, can I mean because our proper identity is the language. That's the truth. So we've got to do everything that we can to ensure that, you know, we bring our children up to date with speed. And maybe you can worry about the don't know how in school. You know, and I want to equally challenge our brothers in this land, our brothers in all one. We need more of these things. But if you are there, you have something that you can offer to teach. I want people to teach Asian people, you know, that's why we don't lose our languages. These are uniquely ours, you know, and we can't get it from anywhere. You understand what I'm saying? And so I invite you, come onto the program. Ibota, this is Ibota. Let's begin to discuss our language so that we can preserve it. We can, you know, lay the foundation of teaching our children, bringing them to the awareness of who we are, so that, you know, the future itself will be a preserved one for the Edo people. So on that note, my people, I want to say a very big thank you for those who have taken that time out to join us. So in Edo, your children, we're going to take it again. Just we used to sing when we were growing up. That's what one of the way we learned it. A B D A F G H I K L M N O O P R C T U V W Z. It's like that. A B D A F E G H I K L M N O O P R C T U V W Z. So let's play this over and over again. Let's learn from this, and then hopefully I'll catch you guys again. My name is Comrade. Let me say it in the language. Moi ik mongosa no bi oriaki no ye Comrade Lante yariova. So if you don't know someone, can we please let's stay close to Ibota and let's begin to use Ibota as a tool to getting back our language.
Big Comic Show. Yes, the Comic Show. Big Comic Show. Wait, Comrade Lamte Oriake, live on Facebook and YouTube. Like us. Follow us and be the first to know.